Ah, get around, adventurers. Come close and sit by the fire. Rest your weary feet. Let the world chase away the cold of your long travels. For I have a tale to tell, one of struggle, triumph, and perhaps a bit of madness. A tale of a lone coder's journey and the mighty creation that came from it. Story that begins not in a green castle or a wizard's tower, but in a rather ordinary Canadian apartment building, with an elevator that simply refused to work. You see, our hero, Graydon Hoare, a programmer by trade, lived high on the 21st floor. Every day, he'd push the button and wait, but more often than not, the elevator was out of order, and up the stairs he went again and again, until one day, tired and frustrated, he muttered to himself, "Why, oh why, must I endure this endless climb?" The answer, dear friends, lay in dark sorcery of an ancient language, C++. A powerful language, yes, but one cursed with hidden dangers, memory bugs that could crush a program like a dragon's breath upon a village. Graydon, like any good adventurer, was not one to accept defeat. He saw the problem clearly. C++ was fast, but it had too many hidden traps, too many dangers lurking in the shadows. So that night, under the dim glow of his laptop screen, he decided to take matters into his own hands. If no one else would create a safer language, one that could still perform with speed and precision, then he would do it himself. He began to write, crafting line after line, forging a new language that would be as strong as steel and as swift as an arrow. He named it Rust, after a rugged fungus, known for thriving in the harshest conditions, an organism that could survive where others perished. A fitting name, don't you think? Born from frustration and determination, Rust was ready to face the world. Mozilla, those wise wizards of the web, saw promise in Graydon's creation. They took Rust under their wing in 2009, nurturing it, and by 2015, Rust had grown into a stable language, a language ready for battle, one that promised developers their spells would not break with future updates. But even with this newfound strength, Rust was still young, a fledgling in a world of giants like C, Python, and Java. Many looked upon it with doubt. Why use Rust when the old ways have served us well? They asked. But there were those among the adventurers who saw the truth. They were tired of fighting the same old memory demons, tired of stepping into traps laid by C's dark magic. These brave souls saw in Rust a chance for something different, a way to write code that was safe, efficient, and free from the fear of hidden bugs. In 2016, Rust's own toolbox began to grow. Cargo, the trusty companion, became a developer's best friend, managing packages and dependencies like a squire sharpening the knight's sword before battle. By 2017, Rust took a bold step into a new realm, WebAssembly. This new magic allowed Rust code to run swiftly in the browser, opening new frontiers for developers who were tired of slow, clunky scripts. Rust was becoming more than just a language. It was becoming a banner under which many adventurers began to rally. And the fellowship did indeed grow. By 2021, the Rust Foundation was formed, baked by some of the mightiest houses in the land: AWS, Google, Microsoft, and Huawei. They pledged their support, recognizing that Rust was not just another language. It was a way to build a new world, a safer, more efficient world. And then, in 2022, came the moment no one expected. Linus Torvalds, the grandmaster of Linux, invited Rust into the sacred halls of the Linux kernel. For decades, only C had worked those halls, the only language trusted to write the very code that powers so much of our digital world. But Linus saw in Rust something special, something that could protect Linux from the hidden dangers that lurked in C's shadow. The news spread like wildfire. Adventurers everywhere began to take notice. Rust was not just a curiosity, it was becoming a force to be reckoned with. Great houses like Cisco, Samsung, and Canonical joined the cause, realizing Rust's power to guard against the sneaky memory bugs that threatened their kingdoms. Even Google and Microsoft began to wield Rust like a well-honed blade, using it to cut down vulnerabilities in their vast realms of code. And just as Rust was winning those battles, news came from the four reaches of the land. In 2023, at the Linux Plumbers Conference, developers spoke of Rust's growing role in the Linux kernel, with more and more pieces of the great puzzle being crafted in Rust. And then DARPA, the US military's own guild of secretive sorcerers, announced an audacious new quest. They called it the Tractor Project, a grand endeavor to translate ancient C code into Rust. It was like sending a modern hero to save an old kingdom from a curse long forgotten. But Rust's reach went even further. The automotive lords, Volvo, Ford, Toyota, they too began using Rust to craft the software that drove their mighty steeds. From Discord to Dropbox, from Cloudflare to blockchain, Rust was making its mark. It said that Cloudflare alone now handles over 20% of all internet traffic with Rust. That's right, adventurers. 20% of all the information flying around the world carried safely and swiftly on the back of Rust's sturdy code. Now, no adventure is without its trials, and Rust had its share. It had many admirers. Indeed, it was named the most admired language on Stack Overflow for many years in a row. But there were still challenges. The Rust Foundation worked tirelessly to support the volunteers who gave their time and skills to this great cause. Grants were offered, funds were raised, but there was still much work to do. Rust needed more allies, more support, and a broader base in universities and companies worldwide. And yet, the language continued to grow. Even the giants like Google and Microsoft pledged millions to help Rust thrive. New tools were forged, new alliances formed. Rust had become not just a language, but a way of thinking, a philosophy for building the world's software safely and efficiently. And the world began to take notice. Rust climbed the ranks in popularity, even surpassing Kotlin and closing in on Go. It became clear, Rust was a language for the future, a language for the brave. So, what lies ahead on this long and winding road? Rust has won many battles, but the journey is far from over. It seeks new allies, new adventurers to take up its cause. It is finding its way into more classrooms, more companies, more corners of the globe. The US government has declared it a safe choice, but in other lands, there is still work to be done. Yet with every step, Rust grows stronger, more respected, more admired. Remember, Rust's journey began with one frustrated man and a broken lift. But today, it is changing how we think about code, about safety, and about what's possible. It's a language for those who dare to venture into new territories, who see not just what is, but what could be. It is a language for adventurers, for heroes. And so, adventurers, this is the tale of Rust, a story born from pain, yet filled with hope, courage, and a touch of madness. A language that rose from frustration to shine bright in the world of technology. But remember, its story is still being written, and perhaps one day you will help write the next chapter. So rest well, brave souls, and when you're ready, pick up Rust's banner and join the adventure, for who knows what great deeds awaits you.